When you hear the word crystals, what do you think? Do high-rise buildings, jet engine turbines, and computer chips come to mind? Crystals are all around us. Modern civilization depends on them.
What makes something a crystal? It doesn't have to be transparent or sparkle like a gemstone. Instead, the arrangement of atoms on the atomic scale follows specific mathematical rules.
Like the symmetry of the natural world, the atomic world of crystals has structure. The structure and symmetry of materials has a profound effect on physical properties. By looking only at the material structure, we can learn about its ability to deform, conduct electricity or heat, and many other things. Hi, I'm Gene Fitzgerald, and I'm a professor of material science and engineering here at MIT.
And I'm Richard Taylor. We will be your instructors in 3072X, Symmetry, Structure, and Tensor Properties of Materials.
Together, we will explore the structure of crystalline materials. To get the most out of this class, you should have some background in physics and chemistry, and you should be comfortable with trigonometry and some basic matrix algebra.
By the end of 3072X, you will understand the lattices, point groups, and space groups that are used to classify crystalline materials. And you will be able to use tensors to represent the properties of these materials. You will also gain an appreciation of the role that crystal symmetries play in determining the properties of materials. And through class projects, you will explore these structure-property relationships in the materials that you find most interesting.
We hope that you will join us as we explore the world of crystalline materials in 3072X.